Hi viewer, I welcome you to Elim TV. It is the station where you watch and learn. I'll be taking you through Mathematics Form 3, Lesson 3. The topic it is Quadratic Expressions and Equation 2. I'm your tutor, Lucy Mudoni. Welcome. Our lesson goes today, we are going to solve the quadratic equations using the completing square method. That is what you are going to do today. After doing the completing square method, where now you are completing an equation, an expression, not an equation. Today we want us to solve a quadratic equation using the completing square method. Now we have example 1, which is there, where we have x squared minus 5x plus 2 is equal to 0. Then we have x squared. The next step now after that, now I should create incomplete equation. So I should make the equation incomplete. The first equation, it is complete. But now I should make it incomplete. How do I make it incomplete? So I'll take my 2 to the other side. So it becomes x squared minus 5x plus 2 is equal to 0. X squared minus 5x is equal to negative 2. That's what it becomes. So what I have on my left hand side becomes an incomplete equation. So you want to make it complete. And remember, in mathematics, whatever you do to one side, you must do it to the other side. So, after getting that, we have x squared minus 5x. And then, now I should make it complete. This is by taking my b divided by 2 squared to become c. And since now I have negative 5 over 2 squared, on my left-hand side, I should do it that right hand side. I should do the same. Whatever I've done to the right hand side, do it to the left hand side. So the next step is giving me x squared minus 5x. That is after squaring my number there, my c now becomes 25 over 4. So now that is the reason as to why you can be able to get that in the next equation. We have x squared minus 5x plus 25 over 4 is equals to negative 2 plus 25 over 4. Then from there, we do the factorizing of the equation on my left hand side. We factorize it. After factorizing, what do we get? Remember, we factorize x squared minus 5x plus 25 over 4. So in that case now, remember the procedure of factorizing, where now we get the factors, which is 5 over 2x minus 5 over 2x to start for 5. So in that case now, we have that equation. So we factorize it, we get x minus 5 over 2 minus 5 over 2, then x minus 5 over 2, which is supposed to give me a perfect square. And in that case now, what I have is a perfect square, which is x minus 5 over 2 squared, which is equal now to 17 over 4. When I take negative 2 plus 25 over 4, I should get it is 17 over 4. Then from there, we find the square root on both sides. Where we get x minus 5 over 2 is equal to plus or minus the square root of 17 over 4. And in that case now, we get x minus 2.5 is equal to plus or minus 2.06. X should give me a plus or minus 2.06 plus 2.5. And in that case, my x becomes 4.56 and the other x becomes 0.44. So when I take it being positive, 2.06 being positive, I should get 4.56. When I take it being negative, I